What is the command sequencer good for? The command sequencer is a list of manual control commands which you do normally separately. When you execute such a control command, something like this seen in the background happens. A circuit breaker, or in this case, a disconnector, closes or opens. To perform switching operations in a substation, Zenon Energy Edition handles the communication with the IDs and the command processing. In addition, we have introduced the command sequencer, which can additionally automate the command processing. How does this look like in a single line diagram? Here, we just click on this symbol for a disconnector. I say command close, and the disconnector closes, which we see here in a blinking representation and then with a filled out circle. The command sequencer is a graphical editor where you can arrange control commands. These control commands you would normally do in a row when you do them manually. I'll show you an example. We see here this graphical editor with a pre-configured sequence. This sequence will now power this feeder bay. I just start this sequence now, and all necessary steps are done. First, the earthing switch is opened, then the line disconnector would close, the busbar disconnector would close, and finally, the circuit breaker. So, how to start a sequence? There are two possibilities. One is just by clicking on the play button in the editor, which I do now. We see that the disconnector and the circuit breaker of T3, the transformer number 3, are opened. Another possibility is to use a simple Zenon function. I have implemented such a function here behind these buttons. And if I click on the connect button here, it executes a function which then executes the sequence. This is very important for remotely controlling a substation by, for instance, the means of a variable. So even if the command sequencer editor is not open, it would now disconnect exactly with the same sequence what we have seen before. Now I show you how easy and simple it is to create a command sequence. In our 220 kV substation, we want to couple bus A with bus C. For that, I open a new sequence. I give it the name 220 kV couple. And then I enter the steps. First, I enter the step for the disconnector for the A bus bar. After that, I enter the step for the C bus bar disconnector. And at the end, I enter the step for the circuit breaker. Finally, I move the endpoint to the last step. I will now check the syntax and then put the command sequence into operational mode. And now I can directly start the sequence. We see the first disconnector closing, the second one, and finally the circuit breaker will be switched on. How would you have done that without the command sequencer? You would have used a PLC, either a hard or a soft PLC. But who does the creation and changes of the sequences in the PLC? It's the engineer. So even for a small change, you need an engineer to do that. With the command sequencer, it's the operator who does the creation, the testing, and the changes of the sequences. The Zenon command sequencer provides something that is called transitions. A And with such transitions, I can react on conditions, like in my example here. I can toggle two circuit breakers based on their status. I start my sequence, and we see because of this transition is true, means I let things go, this part of the alternative branch is executed. If I do that again, it would do exactly the opposite. And we see that also here in the single line diagram. If you want to speed up something in your command sequence, use parallel branches. I have prepared an example here. We want to connect these two feeders to the lines. I start this parallel branches here, and you see that these feeders are doing exactly the same in a parallel way. The command sequencer knows two different modes of execution. One is the automatic mode, and the other one is the semi-automatic mode, which is actually a stepping mode. I will now show you a rather complex sequence in the stepping mode. I have to click on this button on the menu and now start the sequence. The sequence is stopping at the very first point, and I have to acknowledge each step of the sequence with this button here. And so on and so forth. Imagine a control room with several workstations. At each workstation is working a colleague. How can I tell them or prevent them from using the switchgear I'm using with my command sequence? This is done with a feature called allocation. In my example here, I allocate all switchgear which I need for a busbar switch. I start this sequence, and you see that all switchgear here which are in use are selected. This means they cannot be used by other Zenon network workstations. Manual control commands can be either one-step or two-step commands. If you have a two-step command, this means that you need an additional user action to execute this. This can be a problem in a command sequence. That's the reason why we have implemented a feature where you can tell the system either to use a two-step command only in manual mode, or if you use the same command in the sequence, use it as a one-step command, like I show you here. I want to close this circuit breaker, and now I have to confirm that with an additional mouse click. If you do that with the command sequencer, it works without a manual interaction. If you want to reuse a command sequence, or you prefer to create it offline in your office and then import it into your operational system, this is no problem with the Zenon command sequencer. You just take your sequence, export it into XML, and then re-import it at the controller station. Sometimes it could be really hard to select the right variable with the right switching direction. Therefore, the command sequencer comes with a feature called teaching. Typically, you use teaching in a simulated environment, like I have here on my screen. Now I want to start a teaching sequence, and I'll show you how. I call the sequence 380 kV power up. I put my red dot cursor into the right cell, and now I start with the teaching. First, I close all the referring disconnectors. And now I close the circuit breakers. And now my sequence is ready to power up the 380 kV substation. Before I use this sequence now in the real hardware mode, sharply more or less, I need to test it. And where to test it? Of course, in the simulation mode. So we are still in the simulation mode here, and we have conditions as we have seen that before, but now with our sequence. Now I start the sequence, and I can see if it does what it should. Teaching is the ergonomic alternative to programming. As you can do everything in simulation, a command sequence will always be very well tested. So the combination of the Zenon simulation mode with its command sequencer provides always well-tested sequences. The command sequencer does not need PLC engineering anymore. The operator can do everything by himself. This gives flexibility, saves time, and costs.